You moved to the States as a young child. How was that experience to suddenly land in America and be in a new environment? Do you remember that time? Or?
Yeah. I was cold. It was freezing there, man. You know?
Yeah.
I was 3.5 years old.
No gloves?
From Panama, it was snowing.
Right.
You know? And we came on a ship called the Cristobal.
Right.
They just scuttled that ship less than 10 years ago. Been people bringing people under different flags for a long time.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And we lived in a Panamanian neighborhood, West Indian neighborhood, of course, in Bedford-Stuyvesant.
Mm-hmm.
And lots of music, lots of Caribbean food, you know, of course, you know, people who specialized in spices, especially pepper. Yeah. Tabasco had nothing to do with what was going on in that little community. Your eyes would water by smelling it, you know. It's like you'd be outside the house and it would come outside and make your eyes water. You don't know what's going on.
That powerful.
Oh. And everybody swore by this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
That and a very, very interesting dark brew called Guinness Stout.
Yeah.
That was in the wintertime, because there wasn't much money going around in those families, you know, for all the obvious reasons. But they knew how to avoid certain things that they didn't, so that they wouldn't have to pay for it. And so one of them was the doctor. So when you got a bottle of Guinness Stout, and I was brought up on it twice a month, you get what we call punch. And in punch, Guinness Stout, first was, this is for everybody, but I got a little cup about this big. On the Friday after school, twice a month, and approximately. And what happened was that this was a cold drink made from 6 eggs without the egg white, just the yolks, a cup of sugar, okay, that's 2. What else?
Rum?
No rum. No. Ice cubes. Can of condensed milk, carnation milk or pet milk.
That's
right. Poured in.
Mm-hmm.
And one pint of Guinness Stout. And I tell you,
it kills everything, doesn't it? Any germs.
It kept me very, very healthy. It kept me very, very healthy. Along with, because the next step after that, if you didn't get, if the grip still had you, you know what that is.
Yeah.
Then entered the 4-star general, who happened to be my grandmother.
Oh.
And she said, yeah. Boy, come over here. Yes. You know, it's yes. It's open your mouth. Why? Like, it's apron.
Mm-hmm.
You know, open. Cod liver oil.
Yeah. Wham. Wham.
This will help.
Yeah.
And then, as a follow-up, if I'm coughing, she would take a gob of Vicks, open.
Wow.
And I was like,
yeah.
I was better the next day, no problem. Went to school, no problem. And it's funny how Vicks Vapor Rub is still here to this day.
It's got a special smell.
Oh, man, heavy, heavy on the eucalyptus tree, man.
Yeah.
You know?
It's distinctive.
And, like, the whole thing was, like, so... And everything would just go... Very heavy.
Yeah.
And I tell you, it's, between my mother and my grandmother, kept me and my brother pretty much on a tight rein. As noted by the American, I mean, in the whole the black community in the United States, they divided us, and they had a plan, and it succeeded. And that's this plan, social plan, was to separate the father and the mother.
Yeah.
To make the father a minor player in the family.
A boy.
Yeah. And while mom was already getting a fraction of what any man would get for the work that she did.
Right.
But she also did something else happened. She was manipulated in such a way that she lost respect for her
right.
partner.
Right.
And only now is it coming out,
yeah.
little by little, yeah. how much that actually destroyed the black family in that part of the world.
Yeah.
And the reason for a tremendous amount of problems between black men and women
stem from that, don't they?
Immediately, because we only have to learn from our parents.
That's right, yeah.
And it goes back. Can you imagine 400 years of this? It's been this way,
yeah.
You know? And some people have, the people who have avoided it
yes.
have come around to understanding how this all worked, but they are in the minority
yeah.
by a long shot.
Yeah.
And it's not something that you just change, you know? You can see the difference between the Afro-American black family the colonialist Caribbean black families
yeah.
Who are actually a bit better off
right.
than the Afro-American families.
That's right, yeah.
And how the Afro-American black families, the whole idea of intra-racialism, where they really do not care for their counterparts.
Yeah.
You know, they are in competition. It's all set up in advance. And it's an interesting thing.
Yeah.